When farmers spray their fields with pesticides or other treatments, only 2% of the spray sticks to the plants. A significant portion of it typically bounces right off the plants, lands on the ground and becomes part of the runoff that flows to streams and rivers, often causing serious pollution. But a team of MIT researchers aims to fix that by using a clever combination of two inexpensive additives to the spray. The researchers found they can drastically cut down on the amount of liquid that bounces off. Previous attempts to reduce this droplet bounce rate have relied on additives such as surfactants, soap-like chemicals that reduce the surface tension of the droplets and cause them to spread more. But tests have shown that this provides only a small improvement. The speedy droplets bounce off while the surface tension is still changing, and the surfactants cause the spray to form smaller droplets that are more easily blown away. The new approach uses two different kinds of additives. The spray is divided into two portions, each receiving a different polymer substance. One gives the solution a negative electric charge, the other causes a positive charge. When two of the oppositely charged droplets meet on a leaf surface, they form a hydrophilic, that is water attracting defect that sticks to the surface and increases the retention of further droplets. Leaves of many plants have a natural tendency to be hydrophobic, that is water repelling, which is why they often cause droplets to bounce away. But creating these tiny hydrophilic bumps on leaf surface strongly counteract that tendency. Since the cost of pesticides can be a significant part of a farmer's budget, reducing the amount that is wasted could improve the overall economics of the small farming business, while also reducing soil and water pollution. Decreasing the amount of pesticide sprayed can also reduce the exposure of farmers to the spray chemicals. Based on the laboratory tests, the team estimates that the new system could allow farmers to get the same effects by using only 1/10 as much of pesticide or other spray. And the polymer additives themselves are natural and biodegradable, so will not contribute to the runoff pollution. The new approach would require only minor changes to the existing equipment that farmers use to spray the pesticide into two streams to which small amounts of each polymer could be added. The polymers themselves are extracted from common, low-cost materials that could be produced locally.